Hey guys, we're back with another weekly video. I've been having a lot of fun with this weekly. I also really appreciate your support, especially out on Reddit. All your comments mean a lot. I've tried to change the tiers a little bit, but I think I've done a pretty decent job. Maybe this could have been rotated with this, but we'll see as the list goes on. If you have any questions or concerns, or you want to see something change, please leave a comment. Let me know what you guys think. And if you like this video, please like and subscribe. Blah, 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 blah. Anyway. We're starting off with tier one. Ant, pretty decent pick. If I see an ant, I'll take it, but I'm starting to lean more towards cell pets, and I'll show you a little bit why in a bit. So, blah blah blah. Duck, pretty good pick. You're gonna want to put some health on your units. Duck, you can get once you get it to level two, usually you want to do this around turn three. That way you can access the tier three pets, which half of them are amazing. Then you're going to want to sell your duck, put some health on it, especially an eel in certain situations, and you're going to have a really strong pivot going on. Fish, pretty okay. Fish is good, but the only issue with it is you want to get on turn three or turn four, you want to get another unit to level two, buy a unit, then get your fish to level two so that way it can buff up a tier three. So you're gonna have to be play pretty critical on it. If you need to, I wouldn't wait on getting a tier three with the fish, but it pays off really well if you can hold off. Mouse, if you buy a mouse, expect yourself to lose the first round, but it does pay off pretty well. I'm gonna keep on saying it. This is all about eel for a little bit. Getting an apple on an eel can make or break a certain comp. Marmoset. Very good. I'd say it's better than mouse, and I would say it's a little bit better than duck because the duck buff really only helps one unit, but you're always going to feel good picking up a marmoset. Mosquito, pretty bad. Chipmunk, pretty bad. Beaver, I would say it's okay. Just because you can sell and put it onto another unit, which might be nice. Otter is garbage, and Gecko is right behind it. In fact, I'd even say Otter is the worst weakly tier one unit, just because whenever you're buying it, you're buffing these units that you're gonna want to sell. It doesn't really make any sense. Yeah, I can maybe help you survive one round where you don't lose any HP, but it's honestly not worth it. Apple is a good pick. And situationally, a great pick. I'm kind of in between these two here. At a certain point, you're gonna want to take an apple. I'll put it as a good pick right now for a certain unit that I'm sure you all are aware of already, but we'll go over it soon. Peach, pretty bad. It's only not in the detritus or the worst category, just because it has some synergies with an eel, basically. I'm gonna keep on talking about the eel. Crab. Now, some people like the crab, and it's very easy to get some attack buffs on your eel. I'm just gonna put it on the higher range of an if you must. There are other units that you wanna focus on, and if you waste gold on a crab, you're missing some of the pivotal units that'll carry you. Worm, fantastic. Very great pick. I think that I might just take situationally and just keep great pick, right? I'm going to say that worm is a great pick. You're always going to want to buy a worm if you can see it. It's a phenomenal unit. Just because of the advantages it gives you sometimes over an owl, but an owl kind of competes right with ne neck and neck with a worm for different reasons. Tabby cat, garbage. I learned what a cap tabby cat does this week, and you know why I didn't know about it? It's because it's garbage. Lemur, it's okay. Garlic's on able to be purchased. If you pick a lemur, it's fine, but you're kind of wasting your gold on other units that you want to get. So I'll say it's right about here. Sea urchin, pretty bad. Yeah, you might feel good about getting a level one, level two sea urchin for a bit, but you're wasting your time and your gold when you buy a sea urchin. Flamingo, pretty bad. Yeah, you can pill it, but again, you're wasting your time and gold when you buy a flamingo. Wombat, I apologize, it is right on the length or the scale of a tabby cat. Why are you buying it this weekly? Doesn't make sense. Stoat, pretty good pick. Stoat, originally I didn't really care for the unit, But there are so many good tier 3 options that Stowit is actually, probably screen right here. Stowit is honestly pretty good because you have so many good options. You buy it on either turn 3 or 4 when you're at your tier 2 pets. You wait till you hit turn 5. You sell all of the Stowits you've collected and you pray you hit one of the four good units. I mean, 50% chance of hitting a good unit is pretty good odds. Same thing for Spider. I like Spider a little bit more, even though you have to pill to make it work, which I'll put Spider and pill right next to each other. Actually, yeah. It's situationally, it's great. I would say even one Spider is potentially in the great pick region, but Spider is really good, and you can't go wrong with pilling it because it gives you access to these early tier 3 units. You don't have to worry about leveling it to level 2. It's overall pretty good. Bat is a great pick. If you can't find a worm and you're struggling, purchase a bat. It's really going to help you a lot, especially if your opponent starts putting on garlic or it starts doing later game like turtle builds or something where it'll throw a melon on an eel or whatever, or their jerboa. You can get a bat. The weakness is really important because units have low attack, high health for a majority of the game, especially because of tropical fish. So they trade more than once. The weakness applies more than once when they trade, and you'll find that a bat can kind of help you carry through the mid game. A lot of great comps will end off with a level 2 bat or a level 3 bat. Broccoli, it's okay, along with coconut shrimp. There's situations where you might want to use coconut shrimp on an eel, but it only really interacts well with an eel. Rabbit, pretty good. There's a lot of great food purchases, and if you get a rabbit, I think you're gonna be happy. Even two rabbits are somewhat a obvious like team comp that you're gonna get later on. Emperor Tamarin, don't buy him. I went against somebody who got a level 3 Emperor Tamarin, spent all game trying to get it. To throw it onto one unit, you're wasting so much time and gold on a unit that you could be buffing something else, or it's just a worthless investment, in my opinion. The goldfish, because you're going to want effects more than stats on units and levels on them. The goldfish, if you hit it with a stoa, you can keep it for a turn or two, or maybe a spider. But you're going to sell this once you hit turn 5 or turn 7 and you're looking for certain units. The puppy, if you purchase it, it's not the worst. You can always go for lasagna. The toilet paper can help you in certain situations, but you really want to outscale your opponent. And so lasagna is generally picked. It's okay, it's nothing too important. You can do some really cool tricks where if your opponent has a melon armor in the front and it's their last turn, you can throw a puppy real quick, sell it, put something else. You can pick toilet paper, and the puppy actually can come in clutch, taking away their melon armor for weakness, which is a huge difference. Tropical fish, pretty good. This kind of scaling is very nice. You can easily make a eel to 25 HP with the tropical fish. Then you throw a lollipop on it. Fantastic. Its second target isn't too good because you're hitting like a worm or an owl. But it can make or break some comps. With a lollipop, you can do some swaps that might end up helping you win you the game late game. Owl, phenomenal. It's right alongside a worm. Sometimes you're going to want to choose one or the other. You don't really want to choose both, but if you have both, you're happy to. A level 2 owl feels amazing. A level 2 worm feels amazing. If you take an owl, you're going to be missing one slot. But the definitive how to tell if you're a great player or not in this weekly is when you decide, okay, I've been using an owl. It's been great, especially with my jerboa. Plus, I get an extra 2 gold per turn. Okay, but now I have 1 or 2 HP left on my opponent, myself. I need to say, screw the stats. If I find an apple, I can feed it to a jerboa. But besides that, I'm going to put something like a reindeer in that fifth slot. And then eventually, you're going to have a 10-18 owl. Late game, and you'll be like, okay, I have a decent owl, but you know what? These other units over here probably trump it, you know? I'd swap it for maybe like a fox or something, or maybe I'd consider a second reindeer, a hammerhead shark if I have a level 3, a sauropod isn't the worst, or a cobra or something, right? So there are a lot of great choices, but you need to know when to fill up the fifth slot, and you need to know when it's time to sell your owl, which can be really, it's a lot easier said than done. The bear, pretty bad. If I get a bear, I'm kind of pissed. Same with raccoon. Raccoon, in theory, sounds really good, especially because it's early on. You can get it, you can buff it up, and then you have something that can steal any potential melon armor. But it's, if you're playing versus 1v1s, your opponent can plan on it. Maybe 8v8s, it could maybe go up here, but you really don't want this. Mole, unfortunately, there's not a lot of perks that really stick onto your team. And even if there was, you probably want that over just spawning a mole. It's pretty bad. Eel? Wow. Eel is a fantastic unit. It is amazing. I'm going to put it in God tier again. It is an amazing unit, and you're going to want to purchase this every time you see it, because it stacks really well with your team. And you know what? I kind of want to just put Worm and Owl here, because you're going to always buy them at the same time too. So I will. I'm gonna fill up God tier a bit, but all of these units are a unit, you see them, you're gonna go, oh, this is amazing, you're gonna purchase them, and you're gonna always keep them on your team. And this is what your late game comp is gonna look like, right? So they all work really well together, but you have a lot of choices where you wanna buy it immediately. Garlic, it's a great choice for one of your God tier pets. You can buy it on an eel once. Maybe if you get a worm stacked up enough, or an owl, which is more unlikely, but with a tropical fish, it can help. And I can adjust this a little bit. I can put tropical fish here. You're going to want to throw garlic on it. It trades two or three times. You have a level 2 eel. You get it to 25 HP. It's phenomenal. Salad. Pretty okay. Nothing too great. Lollipop. When it works, it's phenomenal. I can see why it is situational now. When Lollipop works, it's phenomenal. It'll really only work for your eel, because you're going to find once you get it to 25 HP at level 2, it's like, all right, I've already capped out on the HP. I have a tropical fish going, so it's giving it more HP than attack. You're going to have like an 18, 32 eel or something, right? And it's gone past the HP threshold. You throw a lollipop on it, you buff it, you get it back to 25 HP, but now you have a 32 attack, and it can hit past melon armor, which is really important late game for a reindeer, because a reindeer is going to have like 10 HP, 20 melon armor, you've got a 32 attack eel now, and then suddenly you can trade one for one against a reindeer, which is a great late game unit. Blobfish, it's pretty good. It's great with pill. But it's pretty hard to pull off, honestly, and you don't want to really want to have it taking up a fifth slot, so I'm going to say it's okay. Just because the good thing about the blobfish is, yeah, you can level up something, it gives it a little stat buff too, but you waste a slot that you want with the mouse with your owl. Crow, I'd say it's a little bit better. Just because you want to sell a crow, fill up a chocolate spot, or Get it out of the slot that you need for your owl, freeze it, next turn buy the chocolate, right? That also works pretty well with selling it. The chocolate's on the right side. You have a fox for one of your fourth or fifth spots late game. It eats the chocolate, levels up. It can be really nice. Jerboa is king. You're going to be scrambling to get a Jerboa. This is a Jerboa weekly, and it is a great unit. You're really going to like it. Never pass up a Jerboa if you can help it. You can naturally find owls, or you can produce your own owls, and I think you'll be happy. Squirrel, pretty decent. I would say it's on the lower end of the good range. Maybe if you have an owl and you have like an eel, you have a tropical fish, you can throw a squirrel in your comp. That's fine. Just make sure that if you do a worm, no, this will only work for worm. I apologize, not for an owl. If you have a worm, make sure it has more attack than the squirrel, so the food item will pop because it gets turn priority. Then your squirrel can trigger and make it a one cost apple. That's like maybe a level 2 apple or a better apple. Pretty good. Microbe. If you are losing, if your opponent has a garlic or melon armor on the eel, and you need a win more pet, these go hand in hand, right? If you take a microbe, you're going to want to take a turtle. Suddenly you have a turtle on your eel, You're going to usually go a worm comp with this. You're not going to go an owl because you need two pets behind it. You have a level two turtle. You have a microbe. It triggers. It knocks off all their armor. Then you have a turtle. Maybe you also have a reindeer or something that gives itself its own armor. Suddenly, you can swing the game back in your favor, and there's nothing this comp can do about it. Unless they decide that they're going to buy a turtle, which is what they need to do, and then have a reindeer, this can save a game where you're losing against a Jerboa. This is the other comp, is a microbe turtle, and it's great. Caterpillar, pretty bad. You're going to want to be building your own team comp. You waste a spot on this, I'm steamrolling you, right? This is a win more pet, whereas situationally, it can beat you, but generally, you're kind of wasting your time with this pet. Because you're just guaranteeing that you're going to have the same pet as my strongest pet. And yeah, it'll trigger after the EO triggers, but just focus on your own team comp and spread out your stats. Lobster, really good. Isn't that goofy? Lobster is a really good pet this weekly. Only when you're pivoting, right? So you lose the early game. You didn't get lucky. You didn't get an eel. You have a worm. Maybe you have an owl or something. Or you have a tropical fish. That's all you've got is one of these or two of these three pets. And you're miserable. You buy a lobster as your fourth slot if you have an owl. Or your fifth slot if you have a worm. And you don't have both. You have a lobster here that gives stats to an eel. Suddenly your eel catches up to your opponent. Maybe you buy two eels separately, right? And then you force feed one. You have a tropical fish feeding onto it. This stat buff is going to be nice. You have a Jerboa. You buy the Jerboa. It gets the stat buff. Then you swap this out. So this is going to be really good whenever you start to access tier 4, tier 5s, and you're swapping out your team, and then you sell the lobster eventually. But one soul lobster is phenomenal. And it can actually really help you pivot into the mid to late game. And I'm surprised. I usually don't like lobsters. But it is a really good pick. I'd even say it's somewhere like right here. Like it's a great choice, but only one. And you're only going to do this one time, right? Doberman, garbage. I didn't even know it was in the pack. it's not good. Yeah, maybe you can make the comp work if you screw around with it a bit. But this is so early to mid game focus for this comp. Why are you going to make a Doberman work? Parrot. There's probably an argument for a parrot that'll copy an eel. It's too complicated. Don't waste your time and gold. Pear, if you must, it's okay. But it's situational, and generally you're not going to want to waste the gold on it. But it can go on an eel pretty nice. Donut, garbage. Why is it even in this pack? Canned food, maybe your fox can make it work. If you're paying for late game, you're wasting too much time. Cow, pretty bad. You're looking for apples. You're looking to spend gold on your apples. You're looking for other things. You're not really... You're getting stat buffs from other things this weekly. A cow is honestly... Yeah, it can work as a fit slot for your owl. But a lot of times, you're going to want to kind of pass this. I don't know how else to describe this besides... You got to play the game to see how this doesn't really work too well. And the stat buffs are so minor compared to other things. Yeah, it gives a plus 2 HP for the eel, which can be nice. But there's something about it. It just doesn't click this weekly. And you're just going to have to kind of trust me on it. Play a couple games yourself. A seal? I'm sorry. Flame 96. The seal's pretty bad. You're going to want to feed other things. You're not going to want to screw around with it that much. Puma? You can maybe make a melon armor work on it, and then suddenly it always does pretty good, but it's so situational. I wouldn't waste your time. Blue ring octopus, pretty good. You have an empty slot because of the owl whenever you're making it work. It basically acts as a level 1 Jerboa trigger, which is nice. I really like going blue ring octopus if I have the chance. Zebra, not as nice. Because it's random on how it buffs, I'd rather go for more of a wide scale buffing than a random two pairs. But it is an option. Fox, pretty good. I like running a comp, not a comp, a fox kind of mid to late game. Maybe that's my fourth or fifth slot, and it kind of passively does its own thing. You just have to watch out for this pill interaction. I haven't had it yet, but if I had to force feed my fox a pill, I would go insane. And it has these really cool effects as it gets to level 2, where it doubles and triples the effect, and you get a sushi or something. It scatters it on your team. It can be pretty nice, but it takes a bit of work. Hyena? No thanks. Situational, and if you're goofing around with a hyena, you're probably gonna lose. There's probably a comp that works really well with a hyena. I just don't know about it yet. Stingray? It's a decent pick. You have the slot to make it work, but you're usually not screwing around too much with a stingray, but a stinky sock can swing you the game. Also, flashlight for a win more option. If you have 3 health, you take flashlight. If you have 2 or 1 health, you always take stinky sock with this. It's not a bad choice, but it is situational. I'm gonna put it on the high end here, right before Marmoset. Turkey. There's not really any faint choices in this pack. It doesn't really make sense to go turkey. It kind of you kind of think like, oh well, if you like lobster that much, why don't you like turkey that much? Because by the time I get to the turkey round, excuse me, I'm already done with my swings or most of my pivots, so the turkey doesn't really do much. I'm gonna say it's pretty bad. You can also argue that the alpaca in certain situations is pretty good, and it can also work. Instead of getting a lobster, you get an alpaca, you kind of do a little swing, and you hit your very late jerboa, but you get an extra level on it, which can be nice. The issue is that it has negative synergies with an owl, and so you get an alpaca, and if you don't have a jerboa that turn, because this is a 2-gold chocolate in certain compositions, then if you buy it this turn and then you buy the jerboa at the same turn, that's great, right? But if you buy an alpaca and you keep it a turn, your owl spits out a level 2 mouse. Now it gets the level from the alpaca and it's got garbage synergy. So this can only work the turn that you're buying it on, usually, because the only time you have the extra spot is if you're running an owl. Chocolate, it's always going to be a great pick. Great choice to always buy. There's not much to say about it. Sushi, it's okay, right? We're usually getting our wide scaling from an apple or a blue-ringed octopus. It can sometimes be nice with the fox, but it's very situational. Lasagna, it's okay. It can work well with like an eel, for instance, right? You feed it to it, it gets double the HP buffs, plus it might need the attack. So it can sometimes work in certain scenarios. Cobra, some people are making Cobra work behind their big unit with a melon armor. I think that purchasing a reindeer overall is better, and it takes up a valuable spot, so I'm not a big fan of it. Snake is so much better, in my opinion, but to each their own. Cat, it's okay. Yes, I know that there's all these different food options, but you want to feed it to other units, right? And yeah, a cat can fit in your fifth slot. It can. I guess I should just put it as good. It can definitely help with the apple on the jerboa, but the important thing isn't getting the jerboa strong, it's the wide scaling aspect, right? Lasagna can be pretty good on a eel, and the food buffs with a fox can sometimes proc really well. I know it's a food weekly, and a lot of people are gonna say, this is a fantastic unit, blah, blah, blah. I'd rather have a reindeer over this unit. And I keep on going back to you, reindeer. I think it's a great pick. Sauropod, situationally, it can be pretty okay. This can kind of help you roll into late game, but you're going to want some other units. This can be like a good fifth pick because it gives you gold for every food you purchase. You get a free apple, and then you get plus 1 gold on it. It can maybe help you scale later on, but it's pretty situational. Oyster, great pick. And what's great about it is that it works really well with an owl. So we love an oyster. I'm not going to put it in God tier because, I mean, technically it's not its weekly, but I mean, it's right there. It's got to be like right over here. Hammerhead shark, if you can make it work, it's great. If you have a level 3 unit, you always buy a hammerhead shark because then you have this extra 3 gold, maybe 6 gold with the chocolate. You can get out of control with it. But, it's very easy to get these units to level 2. It doesn't make any sense to get an eel to level 3. You'll always get the HP buff besides then, right? Jerboa, you're spending so much gold on apples and stuff that how do you get it to level 3 without wasting like a turn or two? Same thing with an owl and a worm. Getting it to level 2 is usually my cutoff point because I don't care so much that I'm giving the Jerboa a level 2 or a level 3 apple, or like a better and best apple. I more so care about this being level 2 and scaling my team, right? Why am I wasting gold on this? So if you find a situation where you have a level 3 one, this is a fantastic, if not almost god tier. I'd say it's a great pick. But if you don't have a level 3 and you really shouldn't, then it's just an okay pick, right? So I'll put it right here. Leopard, I'm sorry, leopard, there's so many high health opponents that a leopard is kind of falls flat. The lionfish is a little bit better just because you can do a cool lollipop trick, but there's better choices. There's two better choices. An anglerfish can help you if you're struggling to get a jerboa. And that's just how important the jerboa is. Your opponent has a jerboa. You can maybe make an anglerfish work. You're going to have the open spot. So I'd say it's a great pick for that kind of situation, right? Where you can make an anglerfish work. And then you have that open slot because you're running an owl or something. You're going to swap. They have a jerboa. They have these type of units. They have this type of units. And you're struggling to get them to level 2. You have a great shot with a anglerfish. And it's a 2 gold. Get the carry unit that you need, which is phenomenal. In certain situations, this is an exceptional unit. Octopus, really good. This is a good pick. I would say it's probably has priority for like the second best unit that you need to kind of help close off your end game, right? If you get an octopus, this will do a lot better than a cobra will do. This will do a lot better than most of these level 60s will do, right? So I'd pick an octopus over a cat, over hammerhead shark. The anglerfish is situational, but octopus is good. You know what's great? This is going to be your final unit on your team. It's a phenomenal unit, and we really don't pick this till like the last battle, the second to last battle, but it is a great unit, and I even have that over a bat. Reindeer is so good this weekly, because even if they do weakness with a bat or a microbe, you want it to hit the reindeer because it just replaces it with the melon armor, so it soaks up weakness, right? And then at the same time, most units don't have more than 20 attack unless you do the cheeky eel to lollipop. This, at the end game, is going to be 18 attack, 16 attack, 12, 14 attack, you know, maybe a 12 attack. It's usually what you're going to have late game, right? Tropical fish doesn't give attack. It's still great. And unless they swap with an eel with a lollipop, your reindeer is going to get one proc. You can very quickly get this to level 2 because you get that extra gold. Screwing around with this thing, you might want to even sell your owl for a reindeer because it's just so strong. Don't get too attached to your owl when it's 1 to 2 turns away. Just replace it with a reindeer. And it works amazing. This is a great pick. I don't want to put it at god tier because it's not fundamentally necessary for your team. But man, that's a great pick. Pizza, it's okay. Pizza's okay. Chicken leg, that's okay. Ice cream, all okay. I'm not going to complain about it. And your fox eats it up. Fantastic. If you got a cat, works even better. It's a little random. And you're really seeking out an apple in your jerboa. So this is the picks for this weekly. I'm sure I put one of your fundamental units somewhere down here. Please let me know. You know, I respond to criticism. I take a lot of things into account. I know I don't get everything right, but I try to wait until about Tuesday to pump this kind of video out because I want to make sure I get a lot of games in. If you do like this content, liking and subscribing, maybe leaving a YouTube comment helps out a ton with the algorithm. But above anything else, I really appreciate it. Thanks for your time.